So this is going to be a little bit different of video because what I have here is a sunlight alarm that I've been working on. It uses this little microcontroller here. You can see it blinking, connected to a servo right here, which is going to push this lever or switch at exactly 8:45. So it should be in a couple of seconds. Actually, I don't know how accurate this watch is. I have a computer here, but you'll see it. Yeah, and there you go. So now this window opens. So what this is meant to do is be a like sunlight alarm, meaning that like this should wake me up with the sun because my bed is right behind me over there. So as for this actually working, I haven't really tried it yet, but the concept's pretty cool and this was pretty cheap and it was a really fun engineering challenge. And you'll see this like rig to get it to actually trigger is really, really scuffed, but it actually works. And I'm in another country right now because I'm studying abroad for school, but I still found a way to do some stuff. Also, you can see this, the code's still kind of messed up because it triggers like every 10 seconds and just keeps on triggering like while it's during that minute. But like, whatever, it should be fine. So yeah, so now let's go check out the code. Okay, so if we take a look at the code, how this is actually working, it's actually very simple. This is my first time ever using Arduino, and or not, I guess this isn't technically Arduino, it's a different board, but nonetheless, it's the same. I'm using their Arduino IDE to program it. So this is a C++, C like adjacent language. It's not the same, but it has very similar syntax and very similar way of working. And the code I have running here is quite simple. So I guess let's just do a brief overview. So the main things that we have to get working here is the servo itself and then the time zone or the actual time that I need for my alarm. Because what I want to do with this is I want to pull the internet time source, and whenever it reaches a certain time, which I have it rise hour and rise minute, the alarm should trigger. So I have a couple of like constants defined here, and then all I do in the setup is simply just attach everything together, do some configuration, connect to the Wi-Fi. Oh, and I have to have my password here too, so don't connect to my Wi-Fi, guys. But and then we also have this little quick switch function here, which basically just triggers the servo. So Arduino has this handy servo library that literally just does the servo stuff. So I write an angle to the servo, I wait a little bit, I write it back. So it gives you that like clicking servo, and I want to say animation. I mean, I guess it is sort of an animation. But yeah, and then down here, we have the HTTP request. And note that I'm using HTTP and not HTTPS because HTTPS requires like certificates and stuff like that, which I could not be bothered to deal with. So I went the simpler but more unsecure route, but I don't really care. And all this is doing is sending a GET request to the server. And we have to parse it with a JSON deserialization library if it's a successful code. And then I basically just yoink the date, like the hour and the minute, because this comes back in like a standard date format where it's like 2024 and then like May, whatever. And then it has like T and then it has the time. So I just yoink those characters, cast them to an end, display them out to the debug log. And then if the hour is like the hour that I need the alarm to trigger, and if the minute is the minute I need to trigger, we just click the switch. It's that simple. There's a couple of error handling codes, and then I blink the LED here just for funsies, so it blinks every
in seconds, and this code delays for 1,000 milliseconds, then delays for another 9,000. So every 10 seconds, we pull the internet for the time. So that's basically how it works. Very, very simple. The code will be on GitHub if you want to check it out. But like, this is kind of fun. Like, doing the microcontroller code is pretty enjoyable. I might have to do this more often. So overall, this was a really cool experience because I even got to check out a makerspace in Berlin, because when the parts came, the servo at the board actually had to be soldered. I had to go find a soldering station. And I got to check out like the local makerspace, pretty cool community. And the lesson to learn here is, no matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, there's always going to be time for those dumb side projects that take way too much of your time for zero actual use. But they're really fun and really cool. So I encourage you to make something cool. Maybe like send it to me or send it on Discord if I'll be active. I don't know how active I'll be. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Really random video. I probably won't do well, but I don't care. This was cool. So see you next time.